Outpost is a conversation. Tries to approach some questions that are brought up by this letter that Katt Lissard wrote.
It's a letter from Africa that brings a few other things to mind.
Well, you have to learn about other cultures. I mean, I think only Americans ask a question like that.
It's best if you go outpost coming in.
Sort of like, you know, that baby that came out and they weren't sure if it's male or female, or borderline human.
We are all outposts.
The show is basically a response piece.
I've been outposted.
I could sense that about you, actually.
Outpost came from a letter I wrote to friends when I first went to Lesotho in 2005, trying to just talk about the experience of being there and what I was doing. I went there to teach and became involved in a theater project, doing Suzanne Laurie Parks' play Venus, in this little country called Lesotho, which has about 2 million people.
It's a beautifully written letter. It's a letter that describes her first few weeks in this place that was very, very foreign to her.
I read the letter, Katt's letter, and so kind of hold the spine of the piece.
Sunday, February 7th, 2005. Dear friends, I've been in Lesotho for 3 weeks and a couple of days, and it feels both like I just got here and like I've been here forever. The forever because of a theater project I've been working on.
Do you see any faces that are not smiling?
Are you Ted right now?
Why, yes, I am.
Oh, so this is Ted Kaczynski.
Look at where they're putting all the money.
And then you said they were there in whiteface.
Four things happened in my first 5 days here. After my 36-hour journey, I was met at the little airport outside the capital by a car and a driver from the U.S. Embassy. Along with the ride, he gave me a fancy invitation to a party at the American ambassador's house for the coming Tuesday at 6 p.m. sharp.
No. It's a reenactment. All right, no talking.
So I have a bell. My job is to bring us back to the letter and to kind of control. Have a little bit of control. Have a bell.
We're in the Mabou Mines suite space called the Toronado. This is a space that Mabou Mines has had for many, many years, and they have a resident artist program here. And what that is they bring in certain artists, they give them time and space to work on a project.
Mabou Mines has been very helpful, encouraging us to work further on this piece.
Life in America, and what we have to do here in Africa, especially in Africa, you have to spread the gospel of capitalism.
Just the fact, assuming that role, that I'm going to go there, and I'm going to study these subjects.
It's sort of evolving into something through working with performers and getting everyone's ideas and expanding the idea from there.
God, it had to be one of the most interesting letters.
This was really interesting.
I like the format of it. And
what is it?
I love it, and I don't want it to change too much.
Really intrigued by this format, because I think that it's very, very interesting to have a play created for an audience and to have an audience want to start participating back.
It was Katt Lissard's letter to her friends when she was in Lesotho, describing her experience trying to produce a play at the university and the kind of strange resistance she was getting from the U.S. Embassy. I enjoyed it. It was kind of like taking the letter and then fleshing it out.
I think it's absolutely fantastic to go to a theater space and as if you were sitting among friends.
I think keeps drawing me in more and more. It was a lovely piece to be an audience member in.
It was cool. I enjoyed that, and I would like to see it develop.
There's so many things that this thing could be.
It's an experimental conversation, and we all need to be engaging in an experimental conversation with each other to find out the places that we overlap and the places we connect and the places that where we resonate together.
We are all outposts.
Each one of us is our own specific outpost, and we need to leave our own skin in order to come back and enjoy it. And once we step out of our skin, maybe into somebody else's skin, or somebody else's thoughts, ideas, beliefs, concepts, we can come back into our own and maybe enjoy our planet a little better and maybe be kinder and gentler or less psychotic than we were before.